All you debtors out there, contact the hunt. Tell the doc to come a secure party.
Come on,
man. Dep is your weapon. Contact the con, man. What? Credit has got you in debtor mode. So terrified, won't answer the phone. You defaulted on your car loan. About to foreclose and take your home. Credit has got you in debtor mode. So terrified, won't answer the phone. You defaulted on your car loan. About to foreclose and take your home. All you need is proper status, supreme mathematics. When these corporate savages bill you damage, secure party creditor, that's the answer you get from me. To kill you with debt, I stay debt free. I lean on that ass with a UCC. Security agreement. Debt is so broke that they can't pay rent.
Shalom, Star the Doc. What you're about to witness in this video is absolute truth. The people study my methods, became secure party creditors, purchased my books, and eliminated incredible amounts of debt. You too can be debt-free. These are but a few mere testimonies of people that has actually utilized Kahan Tazadok's method and has great success. They've experienced great success and are now living as creditors. They used to be in debt. Me, myself, was in over almost $500,000 of debt that I eliminated. And since that day, I've been living as a creditor. Secure party creditor is your answer. What are you waiting for? Become debt free. The longer that you prolong it, the longer that you remain stagnated, the more stressed out and overwhelmed you will become. Click the link below this video or email tazadokshah@yahoo.com and become a creditor now. You too can live debt free. It is very well possible, irregardless to where you may be right now, if you change your status, if you stop behaving and conducting yourself like a debtor and overcome aphasia, you will become debt free. Let's hear from Crystal and Ephraim. Well, let's first take Crystal, for example. She used Kahan Tazadok's book, The Plug, The Inviolable Man. And she used a debt validation letter to literally get the title to her car. She, like you right now, did not believe that Kahan Tazadok's methods would work until she officially applied it and was startled when she got the car. Let's take our brother Ephraim Smith, who was a little bit on the fence until he was able to discharge his wife's $35,000 car loan, and then later proceeded to discharge the student loan for settlement and closure. They both became believers, as you will too. This is why Kahan Tazadok has actually been around for so long and is the most successful creditor on the web and is always giving you proof to the testimonies of those that's been successful. Click the link. Become a secure party creditor now. Shalom. I am Kahan Tazadok, and I'll prove this message. This is Tazadoktrine. Thunder warning. War mode. This is an ideological war. All right, shalom, 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 shalom. Once again, you're not under the sounds of the voice. Tazadok, and I got the good brother Ephraim right here. And so first I want to start by saying I'm going to be doing another webinar this weekend. Actually, tomorrow, Saturday, and Sunday from 12 noon to 6 p.m. both days. And essentially, I'm going to show you how I got 850 credit score and how you could actually perfect business credit as well. So you definitely want to tune into that. You could actually click the link below this video and register for the webinar now.
And so what I would like to do now, again, as I stated, I have the good brother Ephraim on here. And Ephraim happened to attend a few of the webinars. And, you know, after attending the webinar, Ephraim decided to use some of the information that he used in the webinar. And I'm told by Ephraim that he was actually able to discharge. I won't have him say the company on this. We don't want to violate any kind of copyrights. But Ephraim was able to discharge over $30,000 debt by using some information that he learned in the webinar. So again, this is actually just another testimony. And if you go to the channel, you will see testimony after testimony of people that actually had success with this. But it's the people that really, you know, apply what they learn and they really study and they research it. So, you know, without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and let Ephraim speak on this. Ephraim, can you kind of tell them how you kind of came about my channel when actually attending the webinars? And do you think these webinars are really beneficial? Because some people are still in lingo. They're not sure whether or not they should attend the webinars. They spend a sleazy $100 to attend the webinar. Would you say that it paid out for you, Ephraim, by donating $100? You was able to discharge $30,000? That sounds pretty beneficial to me. But go ahead, Ephraim.
Oh, man. To be perfectly honest with you, it's the best money I've ever spent. I mean, if the webinar was $1,000, I would have actually still benefited because, you know, I just discharged $30,000 from a big bank, a big pretender lender. So, yeah, I mean, I absolutely love these webinars because I get a lot of the information I can't find anywhere else. And then I go back and check all the codes and statutes and everything that associated with getting this relief and everything. And, you know, everything coincides with everything that you talk about. You know, I'm extremely grateful. And so I just want to come on and let everybody know what was going on. And, you know, if you haven't attended these webinars, you're doing yourself a good service by doing so.
Cool. So Ephraim, let me make this clear. You're not being coerced into saying any of this, right? Like, I mean, I don't even know what you're going to say because you know how some people's mind work. Some people stay in a debtor mode and they say, oh, yeah, Todd's a dog probably coerced with him. He's paying him to say that. You have people that really think that way, Ephraim. So let's just make it clear. You're not being coerced or tricked or paid to say any of this.
No, absolutely not. I mean, the thing is, man, when you go back and look at all the information, I mean, why wouldn't it work when you laid out all of the remedies and everything else that's associated with all the everything that you talk about? You know, you dropping all these gems on everybody and giving them all the laws and everything. And if you don't use it, that's your own fault because, you know, it's there in black and white and you just hold them to what they're supposed to do.
So which method did you use to discharge? Well, how much alleged debt did you discharge, Ephraim? Was that correct when I said $30,000?
Yeah, that was correct. $30,000 for my wife's vehicle. We've also sent out two other EFTs that we're getting ready to send out our first notice within another week. But, you know, I think total between the three that we've sent out, that'll be about $85,000.
Mm. And so you was telling me something about after you done this, you went to where your wife went to your credit report. And what was there when she went there?
Well, actually, she went to get an extension on her what she owes on the car payment. Uh-huh. And she was trying to key it in for an additional 2 months of they're doing forbearance on the payments. And it says, well, at this time, we cannot issue you a forbearance on the payment because it seems like the loan, the alleged loan is paid off, we can't give you a forbearance on it. So I was like, okay. And so
that's beautiful, man. That's beautiful, Yashi.
Yeah, yeah, it's crazy. And then she actually went on the website and looked at the account itself, and it showed zero balance on there, man. And I was working at the time, and she called me up, and man, she was almost in tears. She was so excited. So yeah, it is pretty amazing.
So let me ask you, what did she think when you was doing this initially? Was she one of those wives, what are you doing that? You're wasting money. Did she have that perception, or was she just a little bit in limbo? How do you know this stuff is going to work, and so on and so forth?
Well, I mean, my wife is extremely supportive. I mean, she's a really, right. Not good. Only is she a good wife, but she's a great person. And, right. You know, she supports all the stuff that I do. Especially when she knows that it's legitimate. You know, I've showed her all of the laws and everything associated with, and then I've already got my Secure Party Creditor Pack taken care of as far as like the 1st of August of this year. Cool. The only thing I've really been doing is studying and listening to a lot of your videos. Also, you know, I bought quite a few of your books. I don't know if you remember, but...
Oh, I remember. Yeah. I remember.
Yeah, and I've been doing nothing but reading, studying, cross-referencing everything to a lot of the videos that I've read. And, you know, everything just kind of works together. So it's true what you say, man. If this stuff doesn't work for you, you're doing something wrong. The system gets it right every time. Yeah.
And that's what I try and tell Israel about Vod. When Vod kept telling her, this stuff doesn't work, it doesn't work for you because you've done something wrong.
Yeah.
It works for me every time.
Yep.
It works for me every single time if you're doing it right. When it doesn't work for you, that means you've done something wrong in your process, which is why I try to highly encourage people to attend these webinars, because you're learning a lot at these webinars. Tell them, Ephraim, the stuff that I say on YouTube is nothing in comparison to what I teach in these webinars. It's not even close.
And anytime you put out a video, then you go back, and even if you don't attend the webinar, use that same information off of YouTube. Go back, write down everything that's been said. Go back and look at that information in a Black's Law Dictionary, or, you know, the different UCC codes, and you know, everything. Still, even if you don't attend the webinar, which you should, because you're not going to get that kind of information anywhere. I mean, nobody's putting that out like that. And so, you know, like I said, I'm grateful. And I really wanted to show a little love, man, and give back to anybody that I possibly could. And that's why I said, you know, if you got somebody that wants to attend the webinar that didn't have the resources, you know, I would be more than happy to, you know, pay their way to the webinar this weekend. So, I mean, just from what I've gained from this, I mean, I'd like to see somebody else to be able to attend.
Come on. Yeah, appreciate that. Yasha, being the brother, has such a good spirit on him. The brother texted me and said, "Do you know anyone that want to attend the webinar this weekend and can't afford it? I'll pay for." That's the kind of spirit that the brother's dealing with, man.
God, that sounds familiar.
That's real right there, man.
Yeah. See, that's the type of thing that we really, I'm gonna say that's what I look for. You know, when I receive remedy, you know, I just, when I first started using this stuff, I'm over here trying to help other folks, you know, just doing stuff in the background. You know what I mean? You know, phone calls, sending folks, you know, some fiat, you know, when folks come, you know, to my city, you know, being hospitable, you know, that's how you do it. You know, you pay it forward. Most of us always going to return it to you.
So Ephraim, what kind of feeling came over you, Ephraim, when your wife called you and say, it's been discharged. It said a zero balance. That must have felt good, Ephraim, to know that it really worked for you.
It did. It really did feel really well, really good for me. But at the same time, it also goes back to, you know, study thyself to show to be approved.
Con.
I mean, honestly, man, all of this stuff is new to me. Like I said, I just got my SPC and everything done in August. And I know that there's only a small community of creditors. I mean, we're outnumbered, man. And I've always said, if I can help another person that's trying to do the same thing that I'm trying to do, I mean, it's strength in numbers as far as I'm concerned. So,
Con.
Wow, shalom. Hey, that's big brothers.
Go ahead, brother. Go ahead, Ken.
I'd like to personally reach out to Ephraim, because this brother showed me love, man. And I'm going to tell you, I don't know this brother, but I'm going to tell you, this brother right here is what we all should aspire to be. Because he reached out and touched me, man, and showed me love, you know. And I mean, you people don't get this, that's what you must do, because this stuff works. It has worked for me every time. And Brother Ephraim, I'd like to say again, shalom, but thank you, my brother. Thank you again. You are what I absolutely had started losing my faith. I started losing my faith in my fellow man, because so many people don't give a damn about other people. But you know what? In this truth, I found that there is good. There is good in our people. We just need to show it more, extend it more, like this brother Ephraim is. This man right here is what most of us take for granted every day.
You got to understand something, brother. I mean, I'm not one of these cats out here, man, that are trying to get over on people or anything like that. I feel like we were put on this earth to serve each other. And not only that, but, you know, pick up your fellow man if you see him falling down, and, you know, try to help him as much as you can, because when you do, you should expect the same thing in return. So you can't put anything negative out and expect anything but that in return.
You know, brother, you don't talk about it, you be about it. You don't talk about it, you extended love to me, and you have showed that that's who you are. And I myself do that often, but, you know, I don't by no means think that I'm the only brother that does that. But, you know, you gave something very special to me, not just because you extended a very precious gift to me, but you reinstated my faith in my brother, my fellow man. You know, I mean, I take this very serious. The Kahan, all praises due to the Most High, gave him the knowledge and wisdom to bestow this gift upon all of us. And we all should take that very serious, man, you know.
Yeah, I mean, you're absolutely correct, Marty. But then at the same time, aside from receiving this information, I think we also need to, you know, humble ourselves, man, and serve each other. And I mean, if we do that, then there's not going to be any of that jealousy or, you know, male ego issues and problems and everything like that. I mean, if we just keep in mind that, you know, we're here to serve each other, man.
This is the thing. Far too many people claim to be religious and stuff. What has religion ever really given anybody? You know, you pray to to a false god because you're not praying to the Most High. You know, but when you actually become spiritual, and the Most High will recognize you. And through the Kahan, he has given us the remedy to be able to deal with these situations in a real way. What you did should show these other brothers, attend this webinar and get the same knowledge that we got. This works for me every time. The EFT is one process I have not tried yet, but I've did at least 5 or 6 presentments, and I have backed off the black robe several times, And I'm telling you, I could shoot you the court case number where I dropped them back, you know, because see, in this spirituality and in the wisdom, all praises due to the Most High, the Kahan gave us real knowledge, which is spirituality, not religion. So when you join this form, you're going to get what is required here. You're not going to get you praying and nothing happens. You're going to get what you really, really should get. That is, he's going to reach out to you and touch you, just like he did for Brother Ephraim. This brother here.
I'll tell you on before I forget my thought. I really enjoy the fact that when he gives us information, he starts on the spiritual part of it. He gives you the laws and also everything that governs all of these methods. And then after that, you get remedy. And I mean, I initially didn't know how important all three of those steps were until I started attending these webinars. And man, to be perfectly honest with you, you need all three.
Come on.
You know, you need Absolutely. All three of them, because if you don't, you're not going to get the success that you're looking for. Because I didn't realize that it was a spiritual thing. And so unless you move, you know, within that level of spirituality, you're not going to get it. You know, you're not going to get it.
That's why a lot of these people that don't work for, let me tell you right now, it's not that hard to actually do if you follow the process, because everything that you do, you have to be mindful of it, and you have to, you know, the con can't hold your hand with this game. He can't sit up here and tell you how to exercise your presentments or how to articulate that. You should follow the directions. If you do as he directs, it will work for you. It won't might work. It will work. I guarantee you it will work. Because if you're a thinking person and you understand what he's giving you, you should know that it will work. There is no way it will not work. So all you people that's under the sound of our voice right now, if you want the same thing, see, because this is what you're going to get. This is not about just gaining things. These are the things the Most High meant for us to have and meant for us to utilize. And if you do as the Most High directs through power that he bestowed in our Kahan, Tazidak, is going to go down just like he said. Now, how many of you do not want that? How many of you understand what I'm trying to tell you? It is that easy. Come over here to the webinar, join in this form, be a part of something great, and it's going to work for you. It's going to work for you physically, spiritually, intellectually, socially. It will do all, it will transcend into everything that you really want. But when you sit back and you're laying on the ropes and doing the woe is me, you ain't gonna get a damn thing, and you shouldn't get it, because you sit back and you don't want to do what is required. Let me tell you, the Most High is gonna get your ass for that too. So why not cleanse your soul and I'm telling you, if you only knew the peace and the remedy, because my life was in turmoil. I had shit hitting me from every which way but loose. If it had not been for the Kahan, what he gave me, I don't know where I'd be. So I want you to be blessed the same way that I was. And so when he gives us this, it transcends to people like Ephraim that turns around and does as I do, the Khan do, Yashabin does, Mikael does, and all of the other brothers that join this forum. because this is a very powerful union between brothers. I want you to understand that. Now that's the most I can tell you, and do, the rest is going to be on you to believe in what I said. But what I would never lie to you, and everything that I said to you, I mean so passionately, I would almost die for it. And I'm not just talking shit. I mean, so. But that being said, everything I told you comes from my soul and my heart. Please try to understand what I'm trying to tell you here. If you join this form, if you do not see this, that means one thing that is not right for you, and your spirit ain't in the right place.
Right.
And that means this also.
Well,
that means that you will not see your way out because you're not capable of being the person you should be. To reach the kingdom, you need to be able to digest this and understand it. And that's what's up, family.
Well, Marty, I feel like this. For the amount of people that attend these webinars, this screen should have a bunch of people on here because these processes work. I mean, honestly, man, like it's just one of the system gets it right every time. It's like you have to know how to make them do what they're supposed to do if they right. don't. I mean, that administrative remedy, when they don't do what they're supposed to do, then there's you know, we already know that the process you have to start once they deny something is to hold them to their word, you know, hold them to the law. And they know the law, and so they just want to see if you know it. And that's the only thing. They're like, hey, we're gonna deny you because we want to see if you're gonna take the steps to come after us or not.
So we're not asking for a damn thing. We showed them the law. We don't have to ask for nothing and sit back with our hands extended to them. We show them the law and we make them accountable to the things that they put there. See, they put these things there to block us from getting what is ours naturally. They blocked us from doing it, so we show them the law. And that is why it will work for you every time, because the Most High gave us this. He didn't give this to us for them to block us from being able to access these things. So we show them the damn law and we make them sit. We make them do what is required and respect.
Absolutely. Like I said, man, I think more people should be on here that have attended these webinars. Because, you know, they've gotten the information. It's like, what do you do with this information? Are you sitting on it?
They're afraid.
Hey, man, when you're following the law, what is there to be afraid of? I mean, when you can show them, when you show them their law, then they gotta uphold that, man. And you know,
who is doing something? Is it I that's doing something? Hell no, it's them doing something, and I show them the law to make them be responsible for the things that they put in place to block us from getting what the Most High gave to us, Genesis 1 through 26 and 28. You dig?
I just feel like the people that haven't attended these webinars, and even the people that have, you know, it's always been said, what are you waiting for? You know, what are you waiting for? Stop being afraid. They can't, you know, what they're doing to you now is no different than, you know, what difference does it make if you try to go through these processes and everything and get this stuff done and you're successful versus sitting around and waiting for something to happen when you don't put anything in? You don't put anything in, you don't get anything out, bro.
What the hell are they being afraid of? We're showing them the law. So who should be afraid of what? We're showing them the law that they are perpetrating against us, because they're the perpetrators, not I, not you, not this form. not this brotherhood. It is not us that is plundering and pillaging the people. So quit being afraid. Show them the damn law.
You got to man up.
Make them be responsible.
You know what I mean? You got to
man
up. Yeah, you got to man up, because it's like we're the highest form of authority. You know, these people are in place because we put them there, and now they got everybody afraid. I mean, come on, man. That's not how it works. It's for the people, by the people.
Okay, I can use you. So while you're over there being all quiet and scared, you're sitting up here sucking up this knowledge. We see you. We feel you in the background. We know you there. But why are you back there? And then when the hawk gives you a chance to come and speak your mind, what do you people do? You turn around and wrap right back up in your little cubby hole, and you're scared as hell. The Most High does not want you, don't need you, can't use you. It's gonna get your ass death.
Yeah, I feel like I feel like people waste their money in attending a webinar and you don't do anything with it. I mean, that's just my take on the situation. If you're not doing anything with it, then I feel like it's kind of a waste. And if you are, why are you not on here saying something about, you know, the information that's given and the remedy, 30 that's attached to it?
30 racks, this brother just told you he did away with. He did away with 30 racks, bam, like that. You dig? And what part of that don't you understand? You can do it too, but you can't
I got all this done within two weeks. 2 weeks from start to finish with this EFT, 2 weeks.
I'm merely here to speak the truth. If you're living in doubt, if you're without faith, this will not work for you. The belief system is essentially part of the problem. Now let's venture into Crystal. Crystal started attending my webinars. She purchased a book. She became a security party creditor, and she was able to set off an alleged death by doing that validation letter that she studied from Kahan Tazadok's book, The Plug, The Invaluable Man, and was actually able to get the title to her conveyance and became exceedingly grateful.
Kahan Tazadok is up in here, man.
So click the link below and go ahead and register for your webinar now, man. You heard? Tell them what from this war, man. Go with your kid. Tell them what it is.
Kahan Tazadok. This is Tazadok Doctrine. That's how we want it.
Tanoia Reynolds in the building. E. Moore in the building. Sandra Cole in the building. Crystal Ford in the building. Benaya in the building. Yo, I'ma hit you with something, man. I'ma tell you something, man, about Crystal Meech. She got some remedy by reading my book, The Plug. Like, I can't hold you. She sent me a text today. See, and this is what I don't appreciate about people, man. A lot of people get remedy from me, and they don't come on and give you guys a testimony, so you don't realize what's happening in the background. But she discharged her car, amongst other things. Just so you guys don't think I'm making this up, because, you know, I literally asked her to do a testimony, but, yeah. What is Wake Up Jacob saying here? Let me see, where is that? Crystal Meech right there. Got a barrage of texts from her saying that she used a plug. So I won't
Well, I don't know if you guys can see this, but probably not. She sent a title. She got the title to a car, which actually proves that people that really is blurred out can't see it at all. Jeez Louise. But nevertheless, she got the title to her conveyance by using a plug in those presentments that Cahun tells the doc had in there. Might be able to see it now. Yeah, you can't. Well, this is the title to her car. She literally discharged it and got the title. You can't see it. Knowing you people, you probably think it's being made up. There's a glare. My screen's white, so you can't see nothing. So I can't see it. Anyways, man, that's what it is right there. So yeah, she's be coming to the seminars and webinars and so on and so forth, but if she discharged a conveyance, she literally got the title. It is my prayer that Stefan has that same success. There's another where's this other lady that's getting my books? What's her name? Rosalind. What is she from, Brazil, I believe? I don't believe she's having the same success because she's overwhelmed, but Krista was more, I guess you say, studious. You can see that. Where is this at? That Brazilian lady that had my book. I don't know if she's getting that kind of success, but when I was driving back today, I got a message from Crystal saying that, holy crap. I mean, that's what the joint says. Holy crap, this works. And so she sent this picture of the title and a Verizon text. Asked her to come on and do a testimony. Not for you. Well, not for me, but for you guys. Because I asked her why was she so startled. So what that tells me when people get startled like that is they don't really have faith. I mean, you can't see it. I mean, Kadar was speaking about earlier today, but she literally discharged a car amongst other things. Too bad I can't get you guys a clear enough screen to see that. Now, here's another lady, Rosalind. I don't know if she be on and off. She had bought a couple of my books. I don't know if she's actually had any success. She's holding up the book in one of the videos. Give you guys a sec. Let me see. Seen her put her in one of the videos. Hold on. Let me find. Show you the other lady I'm talking about. But don't quote me on it because I don't know that she's had any success yet. But Crystal definitely had. Because she sent me a message. The problem is when a lot. Oh, this is the lady I'm talking about right here. So ladies from Brazil, Rosalind, I'm not sure that she's had actually any degree of success, but I know she's at least claimed to be reading the books diligently. This lady right here. There's another, I imagine, student of the Kahan that's supposedly studying. One thing I could say about Crystal, she was pretty diligent in her studies. So that should be motivation for you, my good brother Stefan. If you go about it, and she used a plug. She used Kahan Townsend Doc books to plug. She used the presentments in there. She used the debt validations in there, and she got the car discharged. Now she got the title. So I really wanted her to come on to tell you guys. What if I put it all the way to the camera? Nope. Oh, you're just gonna focus then. Let's see. So that's her title right there. You'll see that? Let's see, focus. That's her title right there. So she got this title.
So all you people that's alleging that this stuff doesn't work, no, you don't know what you're doing. That's all of it. That's all it is. So she put, oh, that is Crystal right there. Is that Crystal? Crystal Ford, if that's you, can you come on and tell them how this worked for you? You don't have to show your face. I'm going to put the link in the room. If that is Crystal, come on and give them a little testimony. Maybe that'll light a fire under my man, Stefan. So she said, holy S-H-I-T, it worked. The plug. I'm so excited. Hey, man. Tell him what it is, Gully.
Go on, Tazza Doc. This is Tazza Doctrine. That's how we on it.
Now, this other sister from Brazil, I don't think she's having the success. This sister right here that I put up earlier, Rosalind, I don't think she's having the success because I don't believe she's as diligent as Crystal is. You know, she sent the photo saying, oh, I got your book. And she got another one. She sent the photo, I got your book. But this right here doesn't mean that you're going to have success, right? Applying, reading the book 5 to 6 times, as I stated, and applying it would only bring success. Not just having a book and it's sitting on the shelf. You understand what I'm saying? You have to read it. So if that is Crystal, there she go. There she is right there.
You have to read it.
Hello.
Well, look at that. She came forward. How's it going, Crystal?
She is right there.
When I got that in the mail today, I screamed. I jumped and screamed. I was so excited.
Yeah, you gotta mute your YouTube. You gotta mute your YouTube to get feedback. Mute your YouTube. We're getting feedback. So when you're talking, your YouTube has to be muted. Can you give them a brief synopsis of what you've done? Because I remember you used to be on webinars. But can you give them a brief synopsis of what you done? What exactly did? Because I know Brother Stefan, you on the call? Come on in here. Stefan is about to do the same thing. So this would actually give him some pointers on how to settle off his conveyance.
I just used the plug, the debt validation letter, and I sent it certified and notarized to the bank. And 2 weeks later, and I actually sent them the second notice on Saturday. But yeah, 2 weeks later, I got the title back.
Wow. So there you go. You hear that, Stefan? Stefan the Don, where you at? Stefan the Don, you in the building? Come on in the room, man. There he is. The Don. You hear that, Stefan?
Now, Don.
She has the title to her conveyance. There it is, Stefan.
Don. Quick question. Crystal's already SBC, correct?
I'm in the process. So I got the packet in June. I filed the UCC-1 on June 24th, and I sent the 3 packets to the IRS, Janet Yellen, and Puerto Rico.
Yeah, so basically, if she's done it in June, yes. Yes, she just haven't sent a copy to the UCC division. So basically, yes. Because what's going to the UCC division is only copies. But come on. You got to go ahead and get yours filed, good brother.
Yeah. You know, the reason I'm a little tight is because these people keep reporting late payments, although they have not verified the debt. And it's really pissing me off. I kind of want to go hard at them.
Yeah, that letter helps. The debt validation letter.
Do you have the plug up?
Yeah, I have the plug. I sent them debt validation. I'm on my
Did you use the letter out of the plug? Did you use that debt validation in the plug?
Not the exact same letter.
I will use that letter. Those things that, that's in those books, they literally work. I can't tell you what to do, but it may be idea to, you know, alter it to fit your particular situation. You understand
what I'm saying? Gone. Understood.
Well, Crystal Glenn has that title. Several other people I know had that titles out.
I'm about to get mine. You can believe that, brother.
You should be the next coming on here, huh? You should be the next coming on here. I got mine.
I'm right now. I'm taking a, you know, trust me, I'm the next one. They got the right one for it. Trust me.
Come. Shout out to Crystal for going through with it. Come.
Come on. Big shout, Crystal.
John Hawkins in the building, man. John Holy Hawkins. Wasn't that the owner of the slave ship, John Hawkins? Yeah. Wow. So you you actually validated a few other things, right, Crystal?
Yeah. Once I sent out one letter, I was like, what the hell? I'll just do it for the rest of my credit report and validate everything.
Right.
And one of the issues that I had on my credit report was regarding the student loans. And so it seems like the administrator keeps switching. So I have four student loans and they keep switching back and forth, but then they don't update the credit report. So then it looks like I have like eight loans instead of four loans. So that was a really big deal to use that debt validation letter and then send in a copy of my credit report to those creditors. So it cleaned it up.
Right.
But now I want to officially discharge it. So.
Well, I mean, so, but here's the thing. If a debt can't be validated, then they have to remove it. You understand? The debt has to be able, they have to be able to validate the debt. If they can't validate the debt, then it has to go away because the debt really doesn't have any validity. And so speaking of student loans, that's actually what this particular live stream is actually about tonight. I was going to go over a debt validation letter for student loans, but it could be used for something else. But this particular one is for student loans. So I appreciate that, Crystal. I'm going to go into that because it's getting kind of late here.
Sure. So,
yeah, I appreciate you coming on here. All praise is due to the Most High, man.
Thank you so much for all your work and all your help. I'm reading it every day. Every day I read your work.
Appreciate it. Thank you. Stefan, everything all good? I appreciate it, Crystal. Everything's good, kid?
Yeah, everything's good. You know, yeah.
Man, you say if you grade yourself, it would be 68%, man.
Yeah, because, you know, I didn't send home. Homegirl is representing herself, and I didn't send her a copy of my response. So.
Oh, man.
Yeah. So, you know, it would have been done. I think when I went to court, if he was able to view all the evidence, but he says that's unethical because she doesn't have a copy.
Yeah, but I told you, man, you always have to notice people. You can't do anything without noticing them.
And you're correct, and that was a mistake on my part. That was a mistake on my part. But I'm gonna redo the response and send it again. Affidavit, service to her, the whole nine yards, and you know, and do it again. You learn the hard way, you know. But I'm gonna get it right. I don't think she has a leg to stand on because she doesn't. She's just coming with her opinion, you know. It's ridiculous, man. And what she's asking the court is to stop me from calling her phone, and also to pick up my daughter from a precinct because I advocate for my daughter when. things go crazy and my daughter's in a crazy situation, I have no one to talk to but the mother. So because of this, she doesn't want to take any accountability, and any advocation for my daughter is seen as some sort of harassment towards her. You know what I mean? So it's just, this is what she's asking the court for. Okay. Which is madness, but you know, I'm listening, man.
Yeah, those little things like that in law is very, I tell everyone that you can't bring no suit or anything against anyone. And let me say this, this is not legal advice. I can't offer you any kind of legal advice. Everything I'm giving you is strictly for educational, informational purposes only. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel and please be advised. In law, everything's specific. You can't bring any kind of suit or anything against anyone if you have not noticed them, because you have to give them the opportunity to offer an intelligent defense. So that means I can't just go in court and state something, right? Because they haven't had the opportunity to prepare for it. That's why they have to be noticed. Same thing with us. Even if someone's putting a lien on you, if they didn't notice you, then that lien is not a valid lien and it can be removed. You have to notice everyone. Otherwise, it's not due process. So I would do it again.
Come on, I'm going to notice. She's going to get everything as if she's the lawyer because she's representing herself. And the judge will, the court will get their copy as well. And yeah. I'll be prepared for the next joint.
Come on, I will copy everyone, man. I will copy everyone. I will send them to the clerk, the robe, and her.
Come on, I'm on it. You know, he tried to play me too. He tried to call me Mr. Paris in the court. I'm, excuse me, Your Honor, for the record, on the record, I'm not Mr. Paris. I'm the authorized representative of Mr. Paris. He didn't allow me to come across the bar. He told, I said, my honor, if it pleases the court, may I approach the bar with all my rights reserved? No. I said, okay, then no problem. I'll stay right here. You get what I'm saying?
It's good.
You know, I'm not messing with these people, but I see every time as it was going on, he kept trying to trick me up and get me this, you know, and I had to keep correcting him. No, I'm the authorized representative. Yet he will be available for, you know what I mean? They try to play you and try to see how much you know and try to trip you up on purpose to make you look like a fool. And then once you get anxious, you know you're not going to be able to think straight again. And that's what they love.
But as it go on, you got to admit, you get more comfortable. You understand what I'm saying? As it go on, the exchanges go on, you become more and more comfortable.
Brother, they got the right one for this. I'm either going to learn this very well or I'm going to die trying. There's no, you understand what I'm trying to tell you, Baji?
And Crystal got her? Crystal got her title.
Yeah, I'm tight now, man.
I know they did that.
Yeah, you know what motivated me to ride a motorcycle when I went down to Virginia Beach one time and I saw a girl in a bikini and high heels on one? That's how it makes me feel, right? No disrespect, Crystal, but you put the fire in my ass. Is you know, excuse my language. You put the fire on me, Crystal, because I can't. I appreciate that.
Yeah, I listen to the videos all the time with the testimonies, like David. I love his testimonies. And it just means so much to hear from this family, you know, everyone's successes. So I'm excited today to have my success.
Cool. I'm excited for you, but Kahan doesn't lie. It's important. Attention to detail. And some of us are intelligent in certain areas, but when it comes to procedure and paperwork, a lot of us have to really learn to pay attention to detail, and that is myself. Detail. These people trip you up with detail and procedure. Cool. So I'm back to the books hardcore. I'm going to get a 99, trust me.
A little thing, man, like this guy, you know, his rep called me about the foreclosure. A little thing like, you know, he never done the acceptance of deed and he never settled off the alleged debt. So they came there with, you know, with the sheriff and with a big canister to throw their stuff out.
Calm.
But it gave him a little more time. So yeah, hey, you better go and correct that now. Calm.
Come on, Tazadoc. This is Tazadoctrine.